Hello dear students, today we will discuss about a resolution of a vectors. Okay, so resolution of a vector. It means it is a process of splitting a vector into two or more parts. Yes, it is process of splitting a vector into two or more parts. It is a process of splitting a vector into two or more parts. For example, here we consider that this one is a resolution vector. We make so this vector into two or more parts. So only two or more parts, we consider that infinite number of parts. We just make infinite number of parts. So this process we consider that so resolution of vector. So this one is a vector. We make a number of parts. So this vectors makes a number of parts. So that's one we consider that so resolution of vectors. So each part of so this vector we consider that a component of so resolution of vector. Yes, for example, so this one is a vector, we make a number of parts, each parts of vector we consider that a component of this resolution of a vector. So this reason here we consider that in that resolution of a vector we consider that rectangular components. For example, here AX, it is a vector present along x axis, and AY, so this is also we consider that one vector, it is present along y axis, and here we consider that so this one is a resultant vector A. Yes, suppose we want to calculate magnitude of this vector, it means a resultant vector. So here we consider that a component present along x axis and a component present along y axis. By using these two vectors we easily calculate so this resultant vector. Otherwise we consider that so this one is a resolution of a vector. Yes, okay, so these two we consider that a component of a rectangle. Why? Because so here we consider that these two vectors are perpendicular to each other. These two vectors are perpendicular to each other. So this reason, so these two we consider that so component of a rectangular. Yes, so next concept we consider that components of a rectangle. So component of a rectangle means these two components, along x-axis component and along y-axis components. So these are components of a so resolution of a vectors. Yes. So components of so rectangular. Okay, so here are rectangular components. Rectangular components. Okay, in that rectangular component, so two vectors are perpendicular to each other. Yes, so here we consider that two vectors These two vectors are perpendicular to each other. So this one is x-axis and y-axis. Okay, ax is one vector present along x-axis. Ay, another one vector present along y-axis. Okay, these two are vectors. So this one we consider that O. And at this point we consider that A, and this one is a B. And here, so this one is a, generally we consider that this one is a resultant vector, but here we consider that a resolution of a vector. Yes, so this vector we consider that a A. Yes, OA. OA is nothing but a vector AX, and OB is equal to vector AY. These two we consider that a component along x-axis and a component along y-axis. AX is component along x-axis. So AX is a one of the vector, but a component along x-axis, and AY is another one vector. So this is present along the y-axis. Okay. And here, A we consider that a resultant vector, or we consider that a resolution vector. So this reason, AX and vector AX and AY are components of vector A along X and Y axis. Yes, okay, so AX is a one vector, AY is another vector, so these two we consider that a component of vector A. So these two present along X axis and Y axis. Okay, so next one here, suppose, so this point we consider that a C. Here OC we consider that a vector A. Suppose here we want to calculate magnitude of a vector present along x-axis and magnitude of a vector present along y-axis. It means we want to calculate a component of vector A along x-axis and component of vector A along y-axis. It means we want to calculate magnitude of vector AX and magnitude of vector AY. And afterwards, by using these two vectors, we want to calculate vector A value. So this reason, here, first we want to calculate vector AX and a vector AY. And here we consider that a theta. So this one is an angle between component along x-axis and the vector A. So this one is an angle theta. Okay, so here consider a triangle OAC. OAC. In this triangle, we consider that a sine function. Why? Because in sine theta means, so sine theta means opposite by hypotenuse. We already know that opposite side value. So opposite, these two are equal. So this reason opposite means AY. Yes, and here we consider that hypotenuse, we consider that vector A. So this reason sine theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. So opposite, these two are equal, it means AY divided by hypotenuse vector A. Here we consider that a modulus of a vector AY and a vector A, because we want to calculate a magnitude of a vector AY and a vector AX. This reason sine theta is equal to sin theta is equal to ay divided by a divided by a. It means ay is equal to a into sin theta. Ay is equal to a into sin theta. Ay we consider that component present along the y axis. So this reason, so this value we consider that a sin theta. So a sin theta is a magnitude of a vector ay. A sin theta is magnitude of a vector ay. Next we want to calculate magnitude of a ax, vector ax. So here a sin theta is magnitude of ay, vector ay. Next we want to calculate vector ax value. So this reason again we consider that a triangle OAC. In this triangle we consider that a cos theta in trigonometric function. So cos theta, so cos theta means adjacent by hypotenuse. So cos theta is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse. So adjacent vector modulus of vector ax. Why? Because we want to calculate a magnitude of a vector ax value divided by hypotenuse is modulus of vector a. So this reason here we get a ax is equal to a cos theta. Ax is equal to a cos theta. It means so this vector value we consider that a cos theta. A cos theta is magnitude of vector ax. Vector ax. Okay, so vector ax value is a cos theta. Next one, we want to calculate a magnitude of a vector a. Magnitude of vector a. So magnitude of vector a magnitude of vector a. Again, okay, so here we want to calculate a magnitude of a vector a. So again we consider the triangle OAC. OAC. In this triangle we consider that a Pythagoras theorem. So this reason OC square is equal to OA square plus AC square. Is OC, it means a vector A, OA, so OA vector AX, AC, sorry, OA square plus AC square. Okay, AC square. So AC square is nothing but here we consider that OB. OB and AC both are equal. Is so this reason OC square, it means vector A square is equal to OA square, it means OA AX square plus AY square. So this reason here magnitude of a vector A, it means here we consider that a modulus. Why? Because we want to calculate a magnitude value. So this reason vector A, otherwise we consider that a modulus of vector A is equal to whole root of a x square plus a y square. So modulus of vector A is equal to, it means modulus of vector A means the magnitude of vector A is equal to whole root of ax square plus ay square. So this one is a magnitude of a vector A. And one thing, if you remember that along x axis the component value we consider that a cos theta, and along y axis the component value is a sin theta. We don't consider that always along x-axis component is a cos theta and y-axis component is a sin theta. Now, yavaglu along x-axis oda component barutalre adar value a cos theta, amel y-axis value component ento tindri a sin theta anta tegedukolodilla. A value galu enagutri change agutta. Sometime along y-axis we consider that a cos theta, and sometime along x-axis we consider that a sin theta. So that is depends upon this angle. For example, here ax is one component, ay is another component of x axis and y axis. Suppose here we consider that this one is a theta. Yes, where theta is there, where theta is present. It means, so this theta means angle between component along y axis and this vector A. So this reason here along y axis we consider that A cos theta. Ay is equal to A cos theta and Ax is equal to A sin theta. Yav side theta angle irutha a side ento bekri nanu A cos theta. Suppose here in this diagram, so theta here, so this reason in this side we consider that x is equal to a cos theta and here ay is equal to a sin theta. Where theta is present, in that side only we consider that cos function. Yav side theta irutri a side ento bekri cos function consider madbeku. Okay.